What's good, YouTube? Welcome back to Goated, the Sneaker Podcast. I'm your host, The Third, and today I want to talk about the sneaker news heard around the world, and that is the story of StockX officially removing their guarantee of verified and or authentic items off of their website. I want to talk about why it took them so long to make this move, especially when we live in the world of fakes when it comes to sneakers or even clothing. I personally think it's just impossible to guarantee 100% authentic items ever, especially with fakes just getting better every single day. I want to talk about the statement they gave recently. I want to say about an hour ago, they finally released a statement. And lastly, I want to talk about why everyone is targeting StockX as if they're the only platform to have made this move or let a fake or two slide through. Stick around, stay tuned. I got a good one. Here we go. First things first, we can't talk about this situation without the allegations Nike made a few months ago in regards to StockX selling them fake product. Long story short, Nike purchased a few pairs off of StockX, received those pairs, did their own in-house verification of these items, and pretty much straight up said, some of these are fake, StockX sells fake. That was the match that set this fire, and I believe we are finally at this point in StockX's history as a company because of that situation. I'm not too sure what went down before that or what happened much more after that, but that is the basis of where this story originated from. Is this StockX's way of waving the white flag, of giving in and pretty much admitting or saying that, you know what, yeah, we might have made a mistake? 100% I think so, and I only believe that just because I'm a firm believer in knowing that you can't guarantee 100% authentic items every single time. There's a couple factors that go into that. One, we have humans who are doing this job. A human is only capable of doing the best job to their abilities, no matter what market they're in, no matter what they're doing, and mistakes are always going to be made. This is pretty much StockX saying that, you know, we understand, we get the market that, you know, we're in. We understand the current climate of the market we're in. We understand the climate of consumers that, you know, come to our site for product, for items. And, you know, this is them pretty much saying that, okay, you know what, we did make a mistake. We may have let some stuff slip by, and we're pretty much admitting to or owning up to the fact that it's impossible to guarantee authentic items. It's not doable, especially not in this day and age. And you think it would be, but how are you going to train or teach a machine to catch a fake? It's about time that, you know, they finally come to their senses and, you know, get on board with Stadium Goods, with GOAT, with Flight Club, because those companies already removed their, you know, 100% verified authentic tags from their pages. They removed that verbiage a long time ago. I want to say as soon as, you know, these allegations came out, but that's something I'll talk about in a couple seconds here. I definitely think this is StockX's way of conceding, waving that white flag, and taking some responsibility and finally getting on board with all these other platforms and saying that, okay, it's impossible to do, we cannot do it, it's just not gonna work out. Why did it take StockX so long to make this move? Why did it take them so long to get on board with GOAT, Stadium Goods, and Flight Club? And the answer is simple. There was no way they were gonna be able to do that within a couple weeks, within a month, within a couple months of, you know, these allegations coming straight from Nike. It just wouldn't have been a smart move on their end at that time, because long story short, that would have been them saying, we're guilty, we do sell fakes, we send fakes out. So I believe that's the reason why it took them so long. I believe that's why we're barely getting this news today, all these months later, and this their way of just, you know, owning up and again admitting to them not being perfect. It's interesting to me why everyone's going after, you know, them as a whole, them as a platform, because, you know, again, they're not the first ones to make this move. I understand why it took them long. I understand why they had to wait it out before making this move, but they're not the only sneaker reselling platform who has let a fake or two slide. I'm sorry. I'm sure obviously, you know, no big platform, no big reselling platform is ever going to admit, yes, we sell fakes. No way. None of these platforms are going to do that. Just, it's bad for business. You lose credibility. But we all know that it is happening. We all know that it's happened in the past. We all know that these companies have sent a fake or two out. It's obvious as to why they're being targeted, you know, because of what went down a couple months ago when Nike called them out. But I think we got to show, you know, show some respect or put shine a light on how much power Nike has, okay? As a whole, as a company, and this is just, you know, the sneaker division, the sneaker part of things. Had it not been Nike, had it been any other shoe brand, had it been any other, you know, influencer or any other person, had it not been Nike, I don't think this story would be receiving so much attention. I don't think StockX would be in the news right now or be in that light unless Nike, you know, didn't come for them. We've got to remember that Nike's the big dog. Nike calls all the shots. I'm sorry, like, it is what it is. There's nothing or nobody close to what Nike is and what Nike does or the power or pull that they have. Again, GOAT, Flight Club, they removed this verbiage as soon as these allegations were made all those months ago by Nike. As soon as this story broke, as soon as the word fake and StockX, you know, were thrown up in the air and put together, whoever was at Flight Club or GOAT or even maybe Stadium Goods did a good ass job in making sure that, damn, we can't let this happen to us. Let's go ahead and remove these words such as 100%. Let's remove guarantee. Let's remove all that stuff and not put ourselves at risk just so that we don't get exposed, just so that we don't get caught up and avoid all the bad publicity, which was a very smart move on their end. If you pay attention or if you go to any of the GOAT site or if you go to Flight Club site, even Stadium Goods now that, you know, GOAT bought Stadium Goods, I guarantee you, you're not going to find any type of wording or verbiage of we guarantee 100% authentic products. It's not possible. They simply removed those words because it's not possible to do. StockX is finally coming around and removing their verified authentic, you know, lines or tags because it's not possible to do. Long story short, it's just not possible to do. It's too hard to guarantee 100% of anything nowadays. You don't mess with Nike. You just don't. I mean, you can get away with that crap with some of the smaller, you know, companies. Maybe it's gonna make headlines, it's gonna make news, but it's not Nike. And if Nike isn't attached or tied to this, I really don't think we'd be sitting here talking about it. I really don't think all the new sneaker news platforms are gonna sit there and make a big deal or make it out to something this big. My main point here is that StockX is late to doing this, but again, they're not the only platform to have removed these words. They're not the only platform to have taken out verified or authentic or guaranteed or 100%. These other companies did it a long time ago. Lastly, I want to talk about the statement that StockX gave about an hour and a half ago, you know, leading up to all the news, leading up to everybody giving their opinion and, you know, making it public. So I'm gonna dissect it, I'm gonna break it down, make it real short, real simple. First paragraph: our comprehensive approach remains unchanged. While product authenticity remains core to our analysis, our verification process is a better reflection of our broader value proposition that we provide customers by reviewing all products sold on StockX. Simple. They're pretty much saying that, you know, nothing is going to change in their approach. Nothing is going to change in what they do. Their authentication process is not going away. They're not doing anything differently. And they're going to remain to do their very best at verifying and authenticating items that are sold and purchased through StockX. They're just reiterating the fact that although they've removed these words, these keywords, that is not going to change anything to their approach. They're not going to do anything differently, and they're going to continue to do their best job at making sure you're getting real items. That's all that means. Second paragraph, which is the bigger paragraph: we look at a range of indicators before sending a product onto a buyer, and there are a number of reasons why a product may fail to meet our elevated standard of excellence, including incorrect size, obviously, missing accessories, not so obvious. Missing accessories will not stop your shoe from being pushed through. Trust me, I've received items without my extra laces or without the stickers or whatever other accessories may come with it. They'll still push those items through. Yes, you know, sometimes those authenticators will reach out and let you know, hey, we're missing You know, we're missing extra laces. We're missing the bracelet that it came with. They will reach out sometimes, not all the time, and let you know that, you know, they can either look for a new one or they can send it to you and offer you a discount. So you do have options, but missing accessories is definitely not a 100% guaranteed reason as to why your item will not be pushed through. Because again, they'll make up for it by giving you some kind of credit, some kind of money back, offering to look for another pair with all the accessories, etc. Continuing, a damaged box, that's true. I mean, they will sometimes, if the box is damaged, they won't push it through because, you know, people like to complain about the cardboard box, which isn't news, but sometimes they will still push an item through with not so much damage to the box. At that point, it's, you know, whoever's looking at it, if they decide it's, you know, okay to push through, they'll push it through. If the damage is just too much, then they won't push it through. A manufacturer defect, again, so I'm having a little bit of an issue now. This is all coming to me now. They're not stopping shoes or items or even clothing from going through with a manufacturer defect. It's not, that's not true. I'm sorry, that's not possible. They're not examining each and every item for manufacturer defects. So many things get through with manufacturer defects, whether, you know, it's some missing paint, whether it's some unfinished stitching, whether it's a crease that's not really a crease but looks like a crease. So I'm having a little bit of trouble with these, you know, last couple of things as to why they may not push your shoe through. Signs of previous wear, that one's true. If it shows signs of previous wear, they will not push it through, because obviously if someone's paying top dollar for an item that should be brand new and there's wear to it, they're not going to push that through. So that one is true. Since our inception, StockX authenticators have reviewed more than 35 million products, and we continue to invest in new technologies to use alongside human inspection and refine our policies to best serve the customer. It is what it is at this point. Again, I feel like they're doing the right thing. They're just, you know, nipping this in the bud and getting it completely out of the way so that they never have to deal with something such as this ever again. Again, they should have did it a long time ago. I understand why they didn't, why they couldn't. It just wasn't possible, especially with the allegations coming so strong and so heavily from Nike. But, you know, they're taking care of it. They're fixing the issue. You know, they finally did what they had to do so that, long story short, they're no longer held liable for when you do get a fake or when a fake does get through. They're still going to take care of you, though. They're still a business. They're still a company. We are who drive the market. So it's news. You know, it sucks if you do get a fake, but if that does happen, you are able to figure that out. You just hit them up, you let them know, yo, I think this is fake, it may be fake. They're gonna do what they need to do. They're gonna ask you for additional images. They're gonna have you send it back. They're gonna confirm that, damn, you know what, we made a mistake. Here's your money back, or here's a new shoe. Simple as that. Other than that, I mean, we'll see, you know, what may come from this. We'll see what other news comes of it. We'll see if Nike has anything to say about it. We'll see if StockX has anything to add to their statement and what they're going to do moving forward. I want to thank you guys for watching this video. Make sure you guys follow the YouTube, the Instagram, and the TikTok at Goated_thesneakerpod. And I'll see you guys on the next one.